Sunday of the 10th annual Desert Dog Canine Trial. Getting ready to get started here pretty quick. If I could have everybody stand up and face the flag for the national anthem.
Taking the bike first or am I?
Ladies and gentlemen, we're getting ready to get started. Want a couple of housekeeping issues real quick. When the dogs are out here working on the field, if you could stay still, kind of avoid running around at that exact time. We're going to be working some things close to the baselines here. We want to give every dog and competitor the best opportunity to be successful and get the maximum amount of points allowed. Additionally, we prefer that if you brought your pet with you, that you keep them in the tunnels during the competition. Again, people and dogs can get distracted by other viewing participants of the canine nature. The event today is going to be the handler protection we're going to start with, and I'd like to introduce Rich Macchio from the Phoenix Police Department to explain how the event works.
All right, today we're going to start with the handlers and decoys have all been briefed. Basically, what we'll start with is our first baseline. They'll be doing an escort of a prisoner. When that first agitator gets to the cone, he's going to start jogging to try to bring out some prey driving in the dogs. As he jogs by the blind, the decoy behind the red blind will attack the handler. That's the decoy that the dog should engage. He'll bite him. The handler will recall the dog off that decoy, go over to the orange barricade, send the dog on the cage fighter. We've got a little MMA cage fighting going on over here. The dog should go around the backside, go underneath. It's elevated about a foot on the backside. The dog should go underneath there and engage that decoy. The handler will move from the first orange barricade to the second orange barricade and recall their dog out of the cage. Once the dog's with them at the orange barricade, you can see the closest to the pin out there. We have a decoy way out behind that red blind back there. You can see him moving. The handler at this point gets to choose how many points he wants to get out of this event. The closer he gets to the decoy before he recalls his dog, obviously the more points he gets. All the way out to 40 points extra, and then the judges have 10 additional discretionary points to evaluate the speed of the pursuit and stuff like that. Once the dog gets back, the team will move over to the black barrel out at about the shortstop location. Make an announcement to the Bermuda Triangle. The decoy will be out in the center between those three Scottsdale police cars. Ascend the dog, and the way it's set up, hopefully the dogs will be going over the hoods of the vehicle and engaging that decoy. Once they're in there, the handler will recall the dog back to him at the black barrel. Once the handler grabs the dog, his time ends, and the event will end. That's what we expect everybody to applaud for, okay? Here we go.
This is for all handlers participating in this event. Go ahead and watch it, more than welcome to, but this is going to go a lot quicker than yesterday. It's probably going to take a minute and a half, 2 minutes. So depending on your number, be ready to go and stage and get going. If possible, we'd like to get the first 10 handlers participating in this event staged with your dogs ready to go in the locker room. One of the things we ensure, ladies and gentlemen, is that the obstacles are safe for the dogs and the handlers. We've noted that the outfield gate is open. People are working back there. Again, we're going to close that. Again, keep the safest environment possible for people watching, the dogs, the handlers, participants, etc. So just bear with us another minute or so.
Handler up from Scottsdale Healthcare is Officer Jim Sullivan and his canine partner, Ada. Jim's been an officer for 19 years and a handler for 12, and Ada is a 6-year-old Czech Shepherd.
Thank you. You know, maybe that was your husband out there.
How about that? Scottsdale Healthcare has Officer Jim Sullivan and his canine partner Adam. Jim and Adam's participation here today was sponsored by Brad Smith and Canine Tactical Operations.
Thank you.
Entering the field from Phoenix PD is Brian Hanania and his canine partner Cirrus. Brian's been an officer for 15 years and a handler for 8, and Cirrus is an 8-year-old Belgian Malinois.
He did better last year. Entering the field now from the United States Army
is Sergeant Michael Brickles, currently assigned to Fort Huachuca, and his canine partner, Chico. Sergeant Brickles has been in the military for 14 years and a handler for 9, and Chico is a 4-year-old Belgian Malinois.
There you go.
States Army has Sergeant Michael Brickles and his canine partner Chico. Sergeant Brickles is deployed twice to Iraq and once to Gitmo with explosive detection dogs during his career. And you didn't hear this from me, but he's also deployed 5 times on Secret Service missions involved with residential and vice presidential security. Is Officer Doug Torres and his canine partner Kenji. Doug's been an officer for 15 years and a handler for 9, and Kenji is a 4-year-old German Shepherd.
Wow.
We have a dog.
$37-inch flat screen LCD TV. It works and everything.